This is a great piece. So you have to understand, so Napoleon loses the Battle of Waterloo, and he gets captured by the English, and he gets sent to the island of St. Helene. In fact, on the right is a painting that we just recently had of him on the deck looking out at France as he's leaving it for the last time. So when America's had battles against other people, you know, often our press and people, and we'll believe that the people we're fighting against were somewhat demonic. There was certainly people that hated Napoleon in England, but there were a lot of people that very much admired him. And thus, when he was sent away, the Prince Regent, the future King George IV, decreed that Napoleon should have the finest of everything, but nothing that reminded him of his past glory. And so they hired the best furniture maker and designer in England of the day, a man named George Bullock, to design his furniture for him and design his toiletry kit. What's his toiletry kit? He would have had a foot bath. He would have had a wash and basin for his hands. He would have had, you know, obviously a chamber pot. And he would have had these things. And so, and because of Napoleon's importance in his day, the House of Lords asked everything to be sent to Napoleon on St. Helene to be displayed at the House of Lords before it was sent. And so it was sent to House of Lords. And lo and behold, one of the House of Lords members said, you can't send to China the toiletry set because it has laurel wreaths on it, and laurel wreaths are a sign of victory. So this foot bath, which was the only one ever made for Napoleon, was never sent to him. So he never quite put his feet in there, but it also has an interesting history after that. Certainly for me, it does. It went to Matthew Bolton. Matthew Bolton was famous for two things. In the antique world, he was famous because he was the inventor of Sheffield silver, that wonderful rolled over silver that was the first silver that really looked like sterling silver and acted like sterling silver, but it wasn't. And that he was also in the scientific world important because he was one of the helpers to James Watt of the original steam engine. So this goes to one of the most famous inventors of the 19th century, which very much intrigues me. But what really I love is the fact that it was made for Napoleon, never given to him. I don't want to say gifted, never used by him. But it's still really, it's just a really cool piece. And it's quite large. I mean, I'm guessing our measurements are on our website. It's probably 22, 24 inches long. So, I mean, it's a good solid piece, and I love it.
Mm-hmm. All right. So two questions following this item. The first, was George Bullock commissioned to make all of the pieces for Napoleon in Exile? I've been to your gallery and saw that you also had Napoleon's desk that was by Bullock.
That's a great question. The answer is yes. It was just his furniture and the toiletry set. Now, whether they were sending sheets for the beds and all, and that came through him, I have no idea. But those are things that wouldn't have lasted.
Great. Thank you. And then a second question, does MS Rao have any connections to the Bonaparte family?
No, I wish we did. We have lots of connections to Bonaparte collectors. I wish we did. And the Bonaparte family, you know, they were somewhat dispersed, and so they weren't like a lot of other imperial families, royal families that somewhat kept their titles and stayed famous and, you know, with a lot of money. But I wish we did. But we have a lot of Napoleonic collectors, and thankfully, because it's something that we care a lot about.